permit application for permits all on Montrose.
Montrose, ladies and gentlemen, we have, in the past, the application, I received some information from the Watts City across the golf course. I think between the two, they were pretty much detailed, and, I'd like to have y'all consider this. Mr. Simpson, you want to?
I went through it and made some very minor formatting changes and corrected, about three typos that may have been in my assistant type, but other than that, I didn't make any substantive changes to it. It does what you and the mayor asked me to have something to do, but this doesn't.
Do what you say you want to do, what?
Just does what you want.
One part of it, we're trying to get a little flexibility.
Yeah.
The one thing that I second your motion to accept this, but where it says that selling or consumption of alcoholic beverages on the town green is not allowed without written consent. I would also like to add that, just like the Estes Center, if we were going to allow them to serve alcoholic beverages at a function, that we require that they have at least, depending on the number of people attending, one police officer, one off-duty police officer. I know at Estes, we have to hire a military to have a sheriff's deputy. It's been anywhere, I can see it.
So the last pay of security personnel.
Okay, and it has to be longage.
That's exactly right.
I didn't see that, I apologize, I read it before.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion.
I second it.
Mayor, you have a motion, here you go. Mr. Contreras. Gary.
Aye.
Your motion to adopt this as amended.
Yes.
Can I ask one question? Why did you give me the offer, I mean, the oath of the town ordinance?
Just, I shouldn't have.
Okay.
That's tough.
All right.
I have a question to you, possibly. This is of the public, of the people from Longview. Longview says that, right?
Yes.
It says for some, sir, the.
Yeah.
This is perfect.
The rental fee for like the gazebo, if your family wanted to go to the gazebo, you have to pay $50?
I think that's what it said here.
Jim, do you start us at the end of our packets, is this being corrected, the gazebo?
As long as we're.
When I had a permit, TV was not made, and it's not supposed to be in a public place. It was something that said allowed, or should be allowed. Now, I think that those are the corrections I made. We weren't in substantive changes.
Well, I don't think, I've got my comments, I don't see anything about alcohol.
Look on where it says town green rules and regulations. See where it says no glass bottles, no glass containers.
What, go with it.
Just about that.
So someone wants to.
Jim, yes, can you correct?
A birthday party or one of those side gazebos that you charge them for that.
Well, if they want to preserve it, only if they want to preserve it. And if they want to take their chance and they want to say that if it's preserved, I'll also have to go down there and put gazebo close to service private park. We're going to have to have signs standing. But I mean, if there's no one there, there's no problem with anybody just taking their kids and going down the gazebo.
That's what it's for.
That's what it's for.
It's just only if you want to reserve, and these, Gary and I talked about, and then, this is kind of geared for a larger event, if somebody wants to do something where they expect a whole lot of people to come, and they can't afford to have 100 people show up and not have a facility.
What is the requirements for security? What do we do?
It's on the last page you have.
On the page, okay.
Security on page four.
I see that, but I mean,
We didn't look.
You're gonna have, you're gonna be selling alcohol there.
Oh, okay.
You're gonna have permits.
And after, if you do a permit, what do you do anyway?
So unless you're selling alcohol, you don't have to have security.
I mean, if somebody said they're drinking, what if they said they're drinking a diesel or a gas or wine or whatever, what's, they don't have that police on that.
Well, then, they can't, apparently can't have beer.
Unless you have a designated function.
Yeah.
Is that right?
It must be presented right, it was considered on the.
So if you bring a paper basket, it's a bottle of wine.
Gary, I have a question.
You sit there, she flies, sit on the top of the air.
And the.
And you've got the glass.
And the glass.
No, what I was saying was you sit there. Gary, so we're requiring a rental fee, and we just discussed that if you show up and nobody's out there, go ahead and use it. What happens if someone was to show up at 2 o'clock? Is someone gonna be responsible for posting signs on the gazebo? And says this facility is rented from this time.
Yeah.
Or if they have a little.
That's what the recreation.
Right.
It will be there.
It's probably just gonna be a paper plate, something that says down, and say, reserve two times or.
Right.
Right, party. And, I mean, what else can do that to be said?
Yeah, that's all, I would hate for somebody to go out there and set up and then, lo and behold, it's rented at 2 o'clock. So as long as there's some posting out there, so people know that if a certain time is rented to be.
Right.
Yeah, it's almost, well, she lost by that, and never mind. I was gonna say, if you had some sort of standing out, it would be.
Well, it's a, you just go back there and put, you put.
A freestanding sign.
Sign, say, so.
Close to two.
Close to three or four, and he can put little stickers on, whatever he needs to do. I mean, we have designs.
Actually, you're sure that the public will be aware of the rental.
I'm sure if you fight something, everybody's just, so like.
They kind of worked it out, because they did something with the school properties, the parks, and playground worlds, and the area, and it's hard to come. Then, you show up, you use them.
Okay, we have a motion to say that about this as in, is that?
Oh, I'm sorry, are we talking about the park rules as well?
No, just as well.
They're on.
Just on the application.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Mr. Mayor, we excuse the sound of the fire, if I get to.
Yes, we don't shoot you, we don't really need one, yes.
Please, Tom.
Sorry, you engaged it. Park room.
So moved.
Second for discussion.
Yes.
My only comment is about the dogs on leashes that are much required to pick up after their pets. Just because I visit the splash pad golf court with my children, there is a pet issue. They have the same requirement, but no one tends to pick up after their pets. And they also let their pets walk with the splash pad and do their business in the splash pad, which is quite disgusting. I think we need to have, I mean, I love my dog, but I don't know how we enforce it, how to keep it clean, how to keep it on the splash pad.
I don't think we do.
I just think we have dog pads.
It says that no dogs, no animals allowed on pad. Do you not allow?
Yeah, but who's gonna enforce it?
I don't know.
I mean, they say no dogs allowed on pad too.
I agree with you, Dave, as far as keeping cleanliness and control of it, but I can tell you, there are people that are gonna battle people about not being able to walk pick up after the park. I look at they go back. This is saying park rules.
Well, you got, they signed all over the beach down there that says no dogs.
Right.
All of the stuff, they don't pay attention to it.
No, you're making this one.
Put swim pants on your dogs, just like your kids.
Okay, I mean that.
I have a question. I have another question.
Um, I think we need to be on the same page with those. I think that those need to be 8 to 9, or that those need to be 8 to 8. Now, I'm sitting down at splash pad, and it's still 88 degrees at 8:15 with my grandkids, but the park is close to 9.
We're looking for all of them.
Simpler to enforce if you have the same closing time. Okay? So, operating hours of the splash pad, you can be 8 to 9. After 9, you should be closed unless it's a special function. There's a state law that says there's no smoking in any public building or facility. I consider the park a facility.
No, 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 outside.
But it is not a property. It is not a property.
You can't smoke on school property. You have school property.
Can you smoke outside?
You're saying why that can't smoke?
Anywhere at all, so that would probably apply.
board would be okay with it, I think that's what we should do.
Just like the rest of them, y'all tell me if they don't do, I think it's great calls personally.
Well, I mean, great, y'all, do it.
Well, we don't know when it is, what time, I mean.
October 8th at 8 in the morning, when they're gonna start. In the normal 5-day route that you've been doing on all these levels that are requested.
Yeah, I know, you have.
I have to wait in lane, so I'm laying about it.
It's just, it comes back again, the name is, okay. Again, I thank those permission, so, proceed, and also, the police department will be burdened with safety.
Hopefully,